Okay, welcome back everybody to Coffee and Art in the Morning. I'm Dee Dee, and now we did a segment just a minute ago on using magazine journals to turn into quote books or word definitions or any kind of thing that you want to use words in using old magazines. So peruse the awesomeness that is a magazine journal on the previous segment. I always say that, you know, and then talking about getting out word definitions and the books on words. And then we always say, check it out. So that's why we say peruse the awesomeness. Okay, so I pulled out the Imagimorphia color book that I haven't worked in a while, but a few of the girls are working in it. So I thought I'd go ahead and do something in this one. And so there was one Saturday a few weeks ago where I went through and did a wash over all the major elements. This is just a wash with no detail penciled in yet. Then there was another segment where we went in and painted the backgrounds on some of them. So some of the backgrounds have been painted in. And then I work on the, like here, there's the background. This one done with all kinds of little scribbly bug movement. The mech beetles. And now this one's finished. I'm not going to finish the little creature stuck in the spider web on this because I wanted you to see the difference between when before they're colored or not. This one is done with just a painted black acrylic background and then Stickles glitter for the web. So I've talked about all these before, so I just want to kind of show you how I'm trying to do different backgrounds, and then I'll just go in and work on some of the tiny bits. So like this one's got a purple background, and then with color pencil did some like almost like they're breaking through the water, you know, with purple pencil. So if y'all have any questions, put it in caps. If you're watching this on YouTube, the recording on YouTube, this is a live show on ustream.tv with a live chat. I'm talking to live people. So you can see there's just a lot of bits and pieces done throughout the book. And I'm doing that on purpose because I want to work through the book. I'd love to finish this book completely. And so what I'm doing though is a little bit here, a little bit there. I might work on a background here, go over here and, you know, just do a little bit like on these dragons. And then go over here and work on the pineapples. And then go over here, you know, so that's how I'm working in this book to hopefully finish it at some point. You like the gorilla background. Okay, so that one, let's go back here. Yeah, so that is a flat paint of acrylic in a burnt sienna, I think. Or was it like a, might have been, I don't remember. Maybe it's a cherry wine. And then I've gone in there with color pencil and done like a little glow with the color pencil around the buildings. This one I painted a gray background. And because it's supposed to look like it, all these creatures are coming out of the steam stack or the smoke stack. So I went ahead and with color pencil, just did smoke. I made you order the flow book, Dorothy. Again, here's where we added some gold paint. Now, the problem with gold paint or any kind of metallics, you can't really go over the metallics with color pencil. So any shading you do, you have to just do the shading with more gold paint or another paint to do the shading. Because you can't really color over with color pencil on top of metallic, shiny paint. And so that's another point to bring out, that the paint that I use is Americana. Just plain matte craft paint. Doesn't say matte on it, but it does not say satin. It doesn't say gloss. So you have to get it where it doesn't say either of those. You do not want shiny paint. And that's part of the problem of using paint out of acrylic paint out of a tube. The high quality art paint, artist grade paint out of the tube can have a sheen to it. And not all of them, and every brand's probably different. I've not tested every brand. I don't use the expensive artist grade paint in my color books. I don't find the need to. Plus, my Americana paints are matte, and so you can use your color pencil on top of them. Okay. So, I did start here in the very beginning doing some backgrounds already. The leopard here is not only has a wash on it, and then I painted in some of the background here, started painting in some of the backgrounds here and here. So you can see, and then some of the ideas of using, I ought to put him on, I ought to put my, maybe I can zoom in enough. I was going to say I should have put my camera on Trippy the tripod. Trippy the tripod is where I can attach you right here, and then I can get you right up close and personal. But I did a separate magazine episode before this one, so I wasn't set up to do that. I'll just try to zoom in. So one of the things about using the tiny bits here is you can use your gel pens, your markers, and I do have here, this is kind of like my color book. Other than my pencils, this is just one of, and I switch around what I keep my products in. This is a, Denise got me this at a yard sale. It's the old Anna Griffin product, pencil holder, or anyway, she got it at a yard sale for me. It's a nice little, zip little case, you can see. So what I put in here right now is my gel pens at the top and my Crayola kid markers down here. Now, this isn't all of them. This is ones I've got multiple sets of these, but they last forever, and you can get them for, they're regularly like $9.99 for a set of 50. And you use a 50% off coupon, 40 or 50%, you can get them for, $5 or $6 for 50 colors. They're just water-based markers. They're kid markers. But they're fine to get into those little details, right? And they don't blend like your Kuretake, like the ones that these here that Eileen got me. These right here, these are actual watercolor markers that will blend because these are actual watercolor in a marker. These are the Zig Clean Color Real Brush markers by Kuretake. And these will blend. But you don't need to use these in your color book. I just, I've used a few in my, like, in some special color book pages. But if you just want to get in some little bitty details like this, you might as well just use, your kid markers, right? Or if you have little bitty tiny bits, gel pens are good for getting in those little tiny bits. Okay, so either one, let me prop this up here. Where's my, prop this up with, so I can have it handy here. So yeah, I love these markers too for color books. I really like these for color books. So what I usually do, as you've seen me do multiple times, is I'll do washes over the big area, like the animals, washes over the big areas, paint in the background. And then, I've added clouds and speckles and shading and all that in the backgrounds. And I've been trying to do different kinds of backgrounds. Like on this castle, I did an orange background. And then I'm working in here. Let's work on this last second. And then I'm just taking color pencil and going in here. Let me go ahead and zoom in now, guys, since I think I've done most of the. Let's still focus. Let me do another focus here, guys. Where's my little card? Oh, where's this? Something to have the camera focus on there. Okay. and then go, how much water do I have for the washes? You water it down enough, Laura, you water it down enough that you can still see your images through it. But that doesn't mean that I'm sopping it wet, okay? I thin the paint out pretty thin, but I put it on a, I'll put it on a palette and wet it down. I'm not like just watercoloring, sloshing water on here. Especially on the thinner books, you always want to test on a back page. But especially on some of the thinner color book pages, it's not even necessarily the paint or the marker that's going through, although I've not found a book yet you can use a Copic on, okay, a color book that, you know, alcohol-based markers won't go through. But it's not even so much the paint that goes through your pages. It's that when you oversaturate it with water, it's the water that's seeping through the page and almost like tearing your book, tearing your page because it's so wet. So if you do want darker layers of washes of acrylic paint, it's best to put a nice light wash on, dry it. I just have a heat gun and I dry it, you know, in between, and then put another wash on. It's best to layer it up in color books. You just can't, you know, just can't saturate them so much that, you know, I mean, this is already, look, fluffy. See, which doesn't bother me. But wrinkling does bother some people. But I found that even if your page is like, let me get my Imagimorphia. I have found, here's the Imagimorphia, that when you, by the time you get done putting all your layers of paint and color pencil on, I can feel a little bit of warping in this page, but it's not like wrinkled. You know, it's got a little bit of warp to it, but it doesn't bother me. But it does bother some people. So just FYI, you know, but look how much pencil and paint is on a page. It's completely full. So by the time you get done with all these layers, you have re-flattened out your page, you know. You will re-flatten out your page. Even though, again, I can feel a little bit of warping to it, it doesn't bother me. Especially then by the time I go to the back page and work on this one, then it'll be extra flat, you know? So, yeah. So that's Imagimorphia. And now, right now, we're working in Imagimorphia. And he's coming out with another one called Mythmorphia, which I'm looking forward to getting that. Mythmorphia. Where's my sharpeners? So I keep my little sharpeners in a little bowl here. I like metal ones. There's the plain silver metal one. Here's the little brass bullet one. And then I have the Kerby wood cutter. It's called the Kerby wood cutter because it's got two sizes there. So now you can get this one in two sizes too. I've got one around here somewhere. But I just keep a little bowl right here so I don't have to constantly be leaning over my trash can next to me. You know, I sharpen so much all day long that if I had to keep twisting and turning, you know, yeah, it's just easier for me just to sharpen over this little bowl. Okay, so again, we can zoom in more if y'all think I need to, but I just want to kind of show you that now I'm going to take my pencil and just kind of, and you don't have to do this in any kind of, or you could do the images first. I'm just trying to get as much done in this book as I can. So I find for myself that if I move around the book and do some backgrounds, some small images, you know, do some washes and whatever, I find I get more done. And then I flip through the book and I see, oh, I got a lot done. So it makes me want to keep working. It flattens out. I use a heat gun to dry. So, you know, I'm constantly redrying things because I get it wet, redry, get it wet, redry. It's not going to flatten out. Look, see, again, see how they're kind of warped a little bit? See how they're kind of warped? They don't flatten out 100%, but it's not wrinkled. It's not like a big wrinkled mess either. It just kind of warps a little. When you break the back of the book to get it flat, do the pages start to fall out? I've not found any book where my pages have started to fall out. There may be, if you try to do that on some of the hardback ones, if they're not sewn, maybe it might happen, but I haven't had it happen. They are like, you know, I mean, I'm really bending as much as I can, and it's, you know, they're in there. No, I've not had any pages fall out that I can think of, any books of color books. Yeah, I trust me, Miss Rose, I've got every sharpener in the mix. I've just found metal ones work the best. I know some people like their electric ones. I don't, for multiple reasons, one of which being I'll go from room to room to work, and I don't want to have to unplug and carry around an electric sharpener every room I go to. When I'm not, you know, when I'm not streaming, I can color in different rooms. Now, when I'm doing commission work and stuff like that, I'm really right here at my desk. But color books, you can kind of roam around with. They're easy to roam around with. Yes, you blend pencils with your over the acrylic. All the acrylic painting is doing is giving it some tooth. Let me show you this test again. I know I've shown it a lot of times, but in case there's people that haven't seen this, I'm going to show my black acrylic paint test. Here, let's see if there's any black paint left in this one. There we go. There's a little bit left. Let me get a piece of paper. Hang on. All right, so I want to show you this with okay, so I'm going to take some black acrylic paint right here. All right, put some black acrylic paint down. Where's baby wipes? I gotta get baby wipes. I'm almost out of baby wipes, guys. That's a national emergency in my house. Not having my baby wipes. I go through those babies as quick as I do pencils. All right, so now I'm going to take black color pencil. And I'm just using Prisma. Now, I know that Kathy Arbor, she has some of the more expensive pencils and she's adept at them. I just pretty much use my Prismacolor. So, you know, there's probably variations on this, but I want to just with your color pencils, but I'm just showing you with Prisma. All right, so now I'm going to take my Prismacolor and I'm going to do a heavy black, dark black. Okay. Just to show you how the difference is of going over something. All right, so acrylic paint, pencil. Now, I gotta let that dry though. You always wanna let your, oh, this reminds me, I gotta send Cam a gel pen. Let me pull that out. My grandson needed some white gel pens, so I told him if I go up there Saturday, Sunday, I'll have to take him some. All right, let me dry this to make sure it's 100. You always wanna make sure that your acrylic paint, whether it's on a wash, or if it's a heavy coat, regardless, you want to make sure it's 100% dry. I cannot stress that enough. I know I repeat a lot of things, but that's one of the things I will repeat every single time I use it because you cannot do color pencil over wet paint. And again, these are not watercolor pencils. You can do things with watercolor pencils over wet paint, but not just your plain old, you know, wax-based pencils. Okay. All right. So here we go. So here is, this is a black acrylic paint and black pencil. Now I'm going to take my white pencil and I'm really going to try to go over this black pencil as much as I can. Now look, I'm pushing as hard as I can and all I'm doing is kind of turning it at the best gray. See, I'm pushing as hard as I can and it will not give me white. Now I'm going to clean that off. I'm going to clean my pencil off. Now this is black acrylic paint. Okay. Let me get my messages are not locked in. All right. Now watch. I'm going to take the lightest touch and just look. Look how you can go right over black acrylic paint. No problem. And when you start to color, I can get pure white back. So you can go over black acrylic paint and actually get it back to almost pure white. See that? There's no way you can do that on pencil. So just a little demo there of some of the benefits of acrylic paint as your base coat for your pages. Okay? All right, let's get back to this. Oh, and as far as blending, let me do a little bit here. Okay, so here, let me just pull this up a little further. Now I'm going to take an orange, and then I'm going to go over the, I'm going to blend into the burnt, is it sienna? What is it? Pumpkin orange. And then you can blend it even more, and then I can get a lighter orange. That's peach. Colors here I got. Okay, and you can just keep blending out just like you would blend anything. Whoops, broken. Just like you can blend anything. Hurts your heart to see that white pencil. You can clean it off. All right, this is one of the bad pencils. Let's try this one. Every now and then I grab one of the old ones that have had problems. A lot of people have said that the new ones, the new sets, do not break like the some of the sets after they first moved to Mexico. Yeah, it was bad. Okay, so start blending this. Oh, that's a peach color. Here we go. Right, so let me go down here and start blending. So you can start to see. You can just blend it as much as you want. And I can even get a lighter shade of yellow. Okay, I got that peach color in there. Where's my Ticonderoga? And as far as erasing pencil, color pencil does not erase very well. I found for myself that I found that the Ticonderoga black, that has a black eraser, is the best eraser to remove pencil. It won't get it back to white, but it will. It's the best eraser I found for color pencil. And you can buy these, they're just like school pencils. They're like school pencils. You can buy them 12 in a box for a couple of dollars. Well, I don't know. It depends on where you are. But anyway, the Dixon Ticonderoga black. See, it says black on there, and it has a black eraser. I found that it erases color pencil better than anything. Okay. So. Yeah, it blends fine. It blends over paint just as well as it does any other paper, you know. I mean, you do have a little bit of tooth to work with because of the acrylic paint. It gives it a little bit of a tooth, you know. But it's not like water, just not to the point of watercolor pencil. All right, so like I said, I'm trying out different backgrounds and things. Like here we started doing a little swirly thing, like well, that was his smoke coming out of his nose. But you can do all kinds of backgrounds. Doesn't just have to be just the flat. Go in there with your color pencils and you know, play like the train here. Like, what's a train? Or here, the mech moths. See, I just did scribbles around them. I did that on purpose. I wanted it to look like that. Here's some of the blending around the dark purple water to make it almost look like they're cutting through. You know how you see them cutting through water and it has like an effect to the water? So that's kind of what I was trying to get by doing the lighter lavender on top of the purple. And again, like there's the King Kong. See? So they're all going to have like different kinds. Here's the train. They're all going to have different kinds of backgrounds. I'm just kind of playing with all different kinds of ways to do things on the acrylic paint. I just picked this one just because we happened to open it here and we got to talking about this one. And the same thing with this one, I'll have, you know, some smoke and coming out of his nose too. Getting a sip of coffee. Please go back to boats. Okay, boats. Okay, I just here, right here, I just forgot to color, get close around that bird, but I just did a flat blue, light blue. Is it this blue that I used? No, it's probably a lighter blue. I'm not sure which blue it was. Anyway, it was a light blue. Was it this one? Might have been, no, I don't think it was Bahama blue. Maybe. Might have been Bahama blue. And some colors like lime green, like citron green, some reds, yellows. Certain ones are a little bit more transparent, and you might have to put two coats to get it flat like that. Okay. And then I've only got washes on here. That's just a wash of blue, a wash of brown, you know, here. So I haven't really done any details in any of this. I think I did a little bit of dark brown here. But yeah, that's all I've done on there. Okay, yeah, I try to get it kind of close up every now and then, Carrie. Like I said, I didn't have a chance to put it on Trippy the tripod because I did the magazine journal first. So, but you can spend as much time or as little time as you want on this. I seem to, you know, I hurry a little bit more. I hurry a little bit more on stream than I do when I'm just coloring by myself. You know, I don't feel any, you know, rush when I'm coloring by myself. So, yeah. And as I'm doing, like, I might have darker right along the edges, and then I just kind of feather and lighter and lighter and lighter pressure. And then you can go in with the next shade. And if you want to practice what colors, like, go together, it's just best to take your pencils and pick a light, medium, and dark of whatever pencil you have. Because I really don't go by numbers. I just look at them and go, okay, that looks like a little bit yellower, a little bit lighter color than that one. And then I'll do it. So I don't go by any numbers or anything like that. It's just that I've done color penciling portraits for so long that I just know my pencils. And that's one of another reason why I stick with my Prismacolors, even though they do have had their issues. See, I picked up that peach again. Where is my orange? That's all right. I guess fine. But that's pink too. Good grief. I need my other light on here. I need an orange. There we go. Sorry, dude, you came late. Which book is... Yes, this is Imagimorphia. Yeah. Yeah, I have them both. This one's Imagimorphia. So you can take as much time as you want to blend all this, you know? And get around all those details. And that was the other thing. When I'm painting the background, I know what I'm going to do ahead of time. Like, for instance, so when I painted this orange, I was not concerned about, like, getting right up on that edge right there. Now, sometimes I do. Like, if I'm painting black, I'll get as close as I can. I go in there with black pencil. But, I knew I was going to go in here with a darker color and so I can get in there and those tiny details. So you don't have to necessarily get your paint right up on the edge if you don't feel confident with your brush skills to do that. You can get in there with a sharp pencil and do those details. Okay, use my bullet one here. This one I think is getting ready to break, but we'll see. So yeah, so hopefully Prismacolor has had enough complaints about their breakage issue over the last couple years that they have fixed the quality control. Because me, Janet, and some of the others that have bought or have had the new sets have not had the breakage issue that we had there for a couple of years. Yes, coloring over paint. That's right. Coloring over acrylic matte, flat matte paint. Not shiny, not gloss, not satin. And I'm not saying no pencils will go over any kind of paint. I've just found that with Prismacolor, that going over just Americana craft paint, not shiny, not gloss, not satin, just plain matte paint. And it doesn't say matte on there. It just is just plain. I mean, it doesn't. The satin and the gloss say so. They'll say satin or gloss. Hello, Kelly Mail. Happy Friday to you. So you can just see. The lighter the pressure, the more feathery out you can do to make it blend. I think acrylic paint as a base feels like gesso. I guess it depends on the gesso. The gessos that I've used are too scratchy for me. I don't use gesso. I just don't. And I know you can probably get golden gessos, probably not as scratchy as some. I just don't like gesso. I don't. It's too scratchy. It's too toothy. So I guess it depends on the brand of gesso you use. You know, it's like with anything. So I'm just kind of. Are you not following along with the prompts, Kangaroo? Kangaroo says she finished her page for the day. I didn't know if you were. I mean, I know that I'm not doing it. I just got done with Inktober, and you know, I do art every day anyway. But I thought there were prompts so that you didn't have to worry about thinking something up. I know Jean does hers. If she does, I don't know. Jean, are you doing it this time? Jean does her music. But she's had some things going on the last week or so that she may not be doing it. I haven't heard if she's doing it. You're going to try and start today and get caught up, but not using prompts. Okay, that's what Jean said. Yeah, so Kangaroo, are you doing your own thing or are you doing the prompts? Well, I guess you're doing your own thing if you have to think something up. Okay, so you kind of get the idea there how that's looking. And again, now I can go in here and, you know, spend more time. The other thing that I always stress over and over, and I know I repeat over and over, is light layers. I can't stress that enough either. Don't go in here and just bear down as hard as you can on that orange to get the dark orange. Then you won't be able to blend anything on top of it. You have to have light layers to blend. Once you start piling up the wax, you can't blend. Hey, Busy Jill. Now it says gesso. Do you have to press harder? I don't use gesso, so I don't know, Anonymous. When I've used gesso, in other projects, I don't like the grittiness. I don't like the grittiness of gesso at all in anything I do. I don't like it. Yeah. My acrylic paint is not gritty. It gives it a slight tooth, but there's no grit. There's no sandy feeling to it. There's no grittiness to it. Do you know what I mean? Know what I mean, Bern? Oh, okay. So some you're using the prompts. Yeah, I'm not, I've never done that throughout the years. The journaling one. I've never done that. The only one that I've really done that I can remember is Inktober. And the reason I do challenge myself every year to do Inktober is because I don't do a lot of inking. I do more color pencil. So doing the Inktober makes me use the ink because I'm not ever used ink because I used to be a calligrapher. But, you know, I'm way out of practice in my calligraphy. I only do the occasional calligraphy piece anymore. So just to use ink every now and then just forces me to like kind of stay in the zone with ink. Does the color pencil look shiny next to the paint? No, not, I mean, it can if you build it up, if you get a lot of wax on, if you build it up. But I'm not bearing down. So it doesn't get very waxy. I mean, I look to the side, I can see the slightest difference. I can't even hardly tell. Hey, Nikki. Yeah, that's the idea with the Nano Jomo, is working in a journal, doing a journal page every day, whether you use the prompts or not. Okay, so there you go. You kind of see how we're going with that around the edges. I'm going to just do a little bit of different parts here. I'll do a little bit of, you know, some tiny things with the markers. I'll do a little bit here with the pencil. Okay, so you can see I've got a wash of green on the dragon here, his body coming through here. And then here's this coming here, and he comes around this one. So that's acrylic paint on there. I try to put the acrylic paint, like here's the castle. It's got acrylic paint. Try to put the wash of acrylic paint on the bigger areas and then go in with the color pencil. Now, on some of these little bit areas like here, I was talking about like using gel pen. Let me just get something here. Let's just get a or something. Okay, something bright so it'll show up. Some gel pens will and some won't go over acrylic paint. Okay, same for markers. I've not had any problems with my markers, my cheap Crayola kids markers going over my acrylic paint washes. However, and, you know, some people do use Copics, but not on double-sided pages. Because, you know, obviously a Copic or alcohol-based marker is going to go through. I would not recommend using Copics over acrylic paint and ruining your Copics. Okay? Just saying. You have to test everything. I can't just say, oh, all gel pens will go over all acrylic paints no matter what. I'm not going to tell you that. And I'm not going to say every color pencil is going to blend over every acrylic paint, just like mine. You need to test them. All I can do is tell you what I'm using. I'm using Americana Craft Paint and Prismacolor pencils. That works. I can't tell you if Luminance is going to work over, Crafter's Choice or whatever paint. You need to test. Okay, you need to test. Whatever you're using, always have a test page somewhere where you can see if it's going to go through, you know, and what's going to happen. Because don't email me and say, oh, I used this acrylic paint and it ruined my gel pen. I told you, test it. Just saying, told you to test it. Okay, so I'm going to stop on the background here for a minute, and just now I'm going to go in here with a dark purple. And another thing about having a test page is also good so that you can just see the color. So, you know, if you just have a place where you can see the color, okay? Now, I have found when I've gone over acrylic paint, I have no problem with these ever going through. But I'm not, here's the thing, I'm not doing this either. I'm just doing that. I'm not doing this. You do that and you're probably going to go through, okay? Don't, you know, you got to test. That's all I can say. All right, so I'm going to take my dark purple, and these are just the Crayola Super Tip water-based. They're not watercolor markers. They will not blend like your Kuretake, real clean color, real brush. These are real watercolor markers, and they're expensive. And I only reserve these for a special color book page. I don't use these every day in my just everyday coloring. They're too expensive for that, in my opinion. But I have used them for special pages, some of the fashion ones or something I sent Eileen. I use these. One I sent Paula, I think I use these. But I do not just use these for my just like getting in there and just coloring in. I found that these work just as fine. But these do not blend, but I'm not using them to blend. I'm using them to do tiny areas, okay? I'm using them to do tiny areas. And personally, I prefer to use the markers over the gel pens, if at all possible. But there's some things that are so tiny that you really want to get like a eyeball of an animal or something, you know? Then, you know, get in there with a gel pen. But again, I usually only use gel pens on their own. I'm not using gel pens to go over the tops of anything acrylic, nor the top of anything color pencil. Let me go back to the one where I have used the, I think it's in the back, the gel pens. I'll use the gel pens for stuff like here, these little bitty trees. See those little bitty trees? I did that with gel pen. Now, some of these I could have obviously easily used marker too, but those are the kind of things I use gel pens for. So this I did all in gel pens just to show an example, and some I even use the glitter gel. See the glitter gel? Let's see if I can capture the shine. I used, there. See, it's got glitter gel pens. Now, I don't think so. I don't think you can refill those, Bunny. I don't think so. Eileen gifted them to me, so I didn't do a lot of research. But I think somebody, I did ask that before, if you can refill those, and somebody said no. I don't remember who told me that, no, you can't. But, yeah. All right, so now I'm just going to go and hit some of the, like, outlines of the windows and the, you know, some of the little more shadowed area with the purple here. They're not refillable. Thank you, Jean. I knew somebody had told me that, but I didn't remember. Okay. If you have any questions, ask. I'll do my best to answer what I know of, you know, what works for what I've tried. And again, I can only speak for the products that, you know, I use. So you can kind of see how we're going from this to this. Yeah, they are expensive, but they are, it's like real watercolor. It's not, I guess, you know, you could probably still use the brushes. I don't know. They seem to last a good long, I mean, I'm not even near running. None of mine seem to be even close to running out. But again, I don't use them. I'm not doing a full-on watercolor painting with them either. You know, I'm not doing a, you know, 18 by 24 watercolor paper page with them either. I don't really think that that's what the purpose of them. It's more for the details, I think. Although you could do small watercolors, like I got these pads of that Annie sent me back. These little pads here. Half of it, the first half is, this is watercolor paper, and then the back pack is like sketch paper. So it's almost like an ATC. So well, actually, it's more of an art card. It's probably about 3x4. But this is watercolor. I could do a little watercolor on there, you know. All right, I'm doing a lot of talking and less color in here. Let me get around all the little windows here. So again, you know, you can spend as much time as you want on all these little details. When it comes down to all individual little bricks and things like that, if you want to indicate things that are, it's kind of like if I draw a brick building, I won't necessarily draw every brick. You can just highlight or color in a few, and it gives your eye the illusion that there's all those bricks there. So one of the benefits of the wash is you've got, you know, I don't have to worry about coloring in all this with a color pencil. Now, if there's anything wrong with that, don't get me, no, don't email me. You want to color every little brick? Feel free. But there's no way I'm going to fill up this whole Kerby book by doing that. Thanks for not speak. Yeah, I don't, all my videos, guys, are real time here on Ustream. Nothing is speeded up and nor are they edited. They're just, my shows are my live show uploaded to YouTube just like they are. So if you're watching the recording, except for the chat, obviously, you can't see the chat we had during the show, but the show is what it is. There's nothing edited, nothing cut out, nothing speeded up. And I know those kind of videos are not for everybody. I totally get that. Not everybody likes, you know, long videos. I personally love them because when I'm working, that's what I put on. I watch other stream recordings, YouTube videos that are long while I'm working. So I love long videos. You don't have to keep, you know, searching for, you know, another 5-minute video. There's, you know, you can just go right to a long video. So if a video is an hour or more, you got me. You got me. I do try to keep them at least under 2 hours, but sometimes, you know, thanks, Busy Jill. Yeah, the people that watch me and follow me on YouTube, they pretty much all like long videos. Otherwise, they obviously wouldn't be watching them. And it's like me. I'm the same way. I love watching long videos, especially at night when Gene puts me to sleep. Gene and I have a running joke about that. But anyway. So you can see I'm just kind of going in there a little bit with the basic. Yeah, and that's one of the things, too, about real-time videos. Not that I'm dissing on speeded up videos, but real-time videos. And I've had people actually comment on me on that before, that they like the real-time videos because they see how long it actually takes to do something. If I speeded up this coloring here on that orange, you wouldn't have seen that it took me, you know, 15 minutes to do that. You can't tell on a speeded up video how long it takes something, you know, unless the person says, you know, in the video how long it took. You know, you're guessing at how long it took. And people get the impression that, oh, I can just do a, I can whip out a color book page in an hour. Well, no, you can't. I mean, I've done a couple in a couple hours here. But, you know, there's more simpler pages and I've really had to push it. You know, and that's really seriously no fun if you have to. I mean, I don't mind doing it faster here for you guys because I'm trying to get as much in a video as I can. But when you're just sitting at home relaxing, you know, and coloring while you're watching TV or whatever, you don't want to have to be, you know, speeding it up, right? I think he asked for a while. I haven't seen Blade, because, you know, ever since he moved to Houston, I haven't seen him reestablish doing videos weekly. I think he's just busy. But, you know, it doesn't hurt to message him or email him and say, hey, Everybody message Blaine and go, hey, where are you? So I just think he's busy is all. He does post on Instagram, Facebook, and I don't really see him post on Twitter much. He posts on Instagram and Facebook. Yeah, the artistic biker Blade. Yeah. Oh, no. You'll never, yeah, we'll never finish every book, every color book page in every book for sure. But, you know, I don't know that finishing is really the objective. I mean, I would love to finish this one just to have Kerby know somebody finished a whole book. But, you know, I'm not putting pressure on myself to do it. If it happens, it happens. Because I am one that loves the process, the journey. For me, it really is about that. Yeah. If I do a page or two in every single color book, you know, and then find the ones I like the best, I'm happy with that, you know. I don't put that kind of pressure on myself. The only time I put pressure on myself is commission work. And even then, it's not like, oh my gosh, I gotta hurry up and get this done. I usually make sure that, for instance, you know, commissions for Christmas gifts and all that, they have to get with me, you know, 2-3 months ahead. I don't do anything like December 15th. Can you do a commission for me? Uh-uh. Nope. Get me next year. Yeah, yeah, I think that he just probably since he moved too. The swirly bits, okay, what do you do with those swirly bits? This, you mean this? Kimmerby, and hi Kimmerby, by the way, this? Is this the swirly bits you mean, or do you mean the little smoky bits? That could be either water, smoke. Jean, by the way, if you want cool free coloring pages. Yeah, and Jean reminds us all the time that Dover, you know, the clip art people. Dover, if you sign up for their newsletter, you'll get a free sample every week on Fridays. Jean said today they have some great pages from new coloring books on the Dover site. So, yeah. The bits that look like clouds or what? Yeah, then I color them to look like clouds or water. Or, you know, if the dragon, they might have, it might be green smoke. Or it could be orange smoke. Yeah, I make it fit the theme. Yeah. Yeah. Same way you color anything else. Yeah. And again, guys, I don't just necessarily just do what they show. Maybe I'll do a color book flip here in a little bit. You know, sometimes I'll add my own clouds, my own, water, stars, glows around things, glow. So yeah, don't feel like you can't make it your own. Make it your own. Add whatever you want to your color book pages. Okay, I'm just kind of looking through here and see what else I want to. I'm trying not to stay on one thing too long so it doesn't get tedious for you guys. I don't like to use the word boring. It's not boring for me to color, you know, bits and things, but it can be tedious, especially if you're watching the same thing over and over. So I am trying to do a little bit of the background, a little bit of marker, a little bit of gel pen, a little bit of, you know, going back and forth. You've been doing yours as water, but I wanted, yeah, well, do whatever. I mean, this could be like, you know, we have the orange fiery sky. Well, what if that's fire in there? Or the fire coming out of the nostrils of the green dragon. Or it could be green, you know, moldy stuff or misty stuff. Or it could just be water. It could be whatever you want. Yeah. Okay, so let's see. I think I'll move on from the, oh, wait, let me do this right here. Move on from this marker onto something else. Maybe a little shading on the castle. All right, so like, all right, so let me get a couple pencil in that color here. And this is how I store my pencils, in bundles by color. Here's all my purples. Now, this isn't every single purple I have, but it is, you know, a bulk of them. I also have a set in my cases, but this is, you know, how I store them for easy use. Part of the reason for putting them rubber bands like this and having them bundled by all your light greens and your dark greens in one, or in two separate ones, your purples, you have your oranges and reds in one, your light greens in one bundle, your dark greens in another bundle. You can pick up your whole bundle like this, like I needed some purples. So I pick up my purple bundle here and I can just do this. And I can just go through here and see every color. That's too red. Like this one I want, this and a lighter one. Let's just go with a couple. And again, on my color book pages, unless it's a face, clothing, something big that I can add a lot of detail to, I'm not going to add 20 shades of purple to this. I'm just not. I'm not. If you want to, nothing wrong with that. Don't email me. And let's see, in a white. So this is the colors that I'll use to do the castle, other than the markers in the tiny areas. Could never find watching UT. Oh, thanks, guys. But, you know, it can get. If I just sat here and did orange sky for 2 hours, it would get tedious, trust me. Unless you're just watching with me in the background while you're working on something else. All right, so. You have yours in bundles? Yeah. Your cats like to eat the elastics? Oh, my gosh. And they do. I mean, you know, they wear out after a while. You have to put new elastics on. You know, ever so often. Same thing if you do a rubber band book. They'll eventually, you know, wear out. That's why I suggest that if you want to make a rubber band book that has, you know, this stretchy stuff to hold your signatures in, I recommend getting the cording, the elastic cording that you can get in the beading department or the sewing department of your craft shop, Michael's Hobby Lobby. I think Michael's and Hobby Lobby both carry it in the beading department. So it's that, you know, it's the elastic cords that are different colors. And those are great for your rubber band books because you can just tie it around and then you can have a string hanging off the bottom like I do my Adorable and have your charms hanging off. Whereas rubber bands will eventually, you know, wear out. Okay, so now I'm going to take my white. Now remember, you saw how white will even go over black paint. This is white pencil over black acrylic paint. Here is white pencil over black pencil. Yeah, ain't happening. Ain't happening. Okay, Carol Renee, thanks for coming. So now I think I want to have some areas that have a nice highlight on them. So like maybe just in the middle here on the front side. You know, it depends on your light source. You can just play with that. I'm just going to have it be right on the fronts of everything. Like the light may be coming from this side. That way you're seeing the smoke and the fire in the back. Okay. So I'm just going to have a direct on light source here. So I might just go through here. And so I hope you can see that. Okay. And again, I'm just, you know, going from thing to thing. If you want to concentrate on one little spot at a time. You know? But your pencil will go over, even white, will go over the top of acrylic paint. Of flat, matte, Americana craft paint. I'm going to be specific there. I can't say it's going to go over, you know, if you're using a artist grade out of the tube that has a sheen to it. Can't promise you anything. All right, so like just start with that. Then I might come in here with the dark purple and start doing a little bit of shading here and there. And I just do very light, light layers. I'm not bearing down. Very light touch. Very light touch. So again, because the light's right in the front here, I'll shade both sides. I might go back with the shingles on the top of these and do them another color. Let's just do a little test here on some of this. So add a little bit of. You say it's okay, and then advertise. Yes, you can advertise your own channels here. Exactly, Bunny. Everybody's allowed to put links to their channels, their YouTube, their blogs, whatever. I don't even care if you put your Etsy stores or anything like that, as long as you're not coming in here and putting it in 20 times. You know, I don't. We share. We, you know, if you take other classes. Like Packer Dye was teaching a class a while back, and you know, if y'all are taking, you know, I don't know what's going on right now. I don't take the classes, but if you're taking classes with someone for the new year, you're free to talk about them all. You know, I mean, but you know, let's just don't go crazy. You know, use some common sense, of course. You know, don't spam everybody, and you know. But mentioning different classes and things, fine. Really begins to build up. Yeah, it does. But it just takes a little bit of time. And again, you know, you don't have to hurry like I might be. All right, so let's just say we'll stop with that. Now I'm going to go in with the lavender color and start blending in some. And you can go in there with a few, like, all right, let me go back to, let's go back to the marker. Let's go back to the marker and let's just do one little section of the tower here. And, you know, you might go in here with a few little bricks. Now, if I was going to do like individual bricks, let me go ahead and do this first. If I was going to do some individual bricks, I'd go ahead and get my shading done. The big bulk of the shading, like here on the sides and underneath here, whatever. And then do the lighter purple with some more shading. Again, you got to keep it light or you're going to lose all your color book lines. I might do, you know, a little bit of that. And then go in with your marker. It's probably not a good idea to try to do all your little marker bits and then shade over the top of that. Because you might smear them. I'm not saying you absolutely positively will. But the little details like this would be something I would do at the end of the coloring process, of the shading process, I mean. See how you can do just a few little bricks like this, just to kind of indicate some bricks and leave some of the lines there too. But you do it how you want. But you see how that, I'm not coloring every brick. And I'm leaving it light in the middle because I'm imagining the light's hitting it directly flat on like this, not coming from a back source. How to shade large areas of snow. Somebody just asked me that not too long ago. With snow, use a slate gray or a blue or a purple, a light purple for your shadows. It depends on, you know, where you are, like, you know, what. If you're up in the Andes or if you're a snow at a lake or, you know, but purple and gray blues, one or the other are the best for shading in white. Like a white beard, you're probably going to have blue in there, you know. Yeah, and some gray. Yeah, gray too. But gray can be very dulling, just gray in itself. And not that there's not a place for that. I mean, there's dull gray, snowy days. But blue and purple are better shadows. Okay. Yeah, light blue. Yeah, there you go. See, Jean's becoming quite the. I'm telling you, you don't know how far Jean's come. Just saying. Those of us that have known her for years, we know how far Jean's come. Okay, so I'm just going to add, a little bit on either side here. Oh, wait, did I? Yeah, let me add a little bit more. Let me color that first. Let me shade. I got carried away. And these are water-based, so you want to make sure they're dry too. I mean, they'll smear, like if the second I put this on, I can smear it. Okay, so you want to let it set up and dry your markers because they will smear until they are dry. Just a few on the front. Something like that. Okay, and then where I have the white highlight, I'm going to just kind of touch the edges of that with the lavender so it's not just like a line. I want it to have a little bit of blending to the white on the sides of the white highlight. And again, I would shade all the painted areas, shade that all first with a couple shades, and then go in there with your marker or gel pen. Aw. There was probably a lot of us, Jean. Okay, now I think I want the little castle tops to be a different color. Even though I've got a, wash of purple on there, I can still go over it with other color pencils. I just have to decide what colors I want them. Don't want it more in a blue. And again, these are my fantasy things here. You're probably not going to see a purple castle, right? Let's go ahead and do a slate blue color. Or a blue and a gray. So I still want a purple tinge to it, but I think I'm gonna go over it and get more of a blue on there, but leave a little undercoat of purple. Can you see that difference there? Now I don't want to color it too hot. If I color it too much, you're gonna lose all the little lines, right? So I think I'm just gonna go ahead and put a light coat of this color just to get dull back the purple, just to make it a little bit different color, but I'm not pushing hard because I'll lose all the color book lines. Okay. So I'm gonna do them all the same. You could do them all a variation. You could have all the different castle parts being all different, but I'm just gonna put a light coat of the slate blue over all the places that have shingles. So it just gives it a little variation. But I'm not coloring so hard. If I push down too hard and try to color it in real flat, you're going to lose all the color book lines. All the little color book lines. That's the benefit of the wash. By having the acrylic wash on there, you have the color, your base color on there without losing the lines. Because if I wanted, let's just say I wanted this castle purple and I was going to use color pencil. All right, so I start by going over the whole thing with, say, just a light lavender, even the lightest touch that I had. Then I started adding some shading. You're going to lose all those lines. You're going to lose your color book lines. What time is it? 11. Okay, well, I don't want to get over. Well, yeah, let me go ahead and just put a light coat over here. want to get in here and do it. I wanted to do a few of the little bits here too. So again, this is not, you know, very rarely can you do a live, real-time color book video and have a page done, even in 2 or 3 hours. I mean, I've done it a couple times with some, you know, a couple of pages, but it's and that's even rushing. You don't want to rush. You don't want to have to rush. I mean, like I said, I don't mind doing it on a stream for, you know, so you guys can see as much process as you can. But, you know, don't email me and say, you didn't finish that page. You're right. If y'all remember, let me get it. If you remember our Bennett Klein Oh Dear page, remember this page? This took us nine parts to finish this page. It's under plastic. It's in a plastic sleeve. This took us 9 parts to do. So we can do a full-on color book page to this detail, but it'll be very multiple parts. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, Jean said her last one took her 10 hours. So, yeah, it's not that I can come on here and do a real-time video, and I just don't want to, I'm not going to speed my videos up. So, yeah, if you don't like watching either long videos or parts of color book pages, you know, then go watch a speed it up video, but that's not going to happen on mine. I want people to see how long it takes. So that they don't, for one thing, it can be discouraging. If you see, and again, guys, I'm not dissing on anybody that does speed it up videos. There's a place for all of it. Some people don't have hours to watch videos, you know, and all they can watch is speed it up videos. I'm not, you know, again, don't email me and say, you're dissing on speed it up. No, I'm not. But I want you to see how long it actually takes to do the detail. Okay, so there I think I got most of the blue, here's another one, shingled areas. Any place that has shingles, here's another one. Okay. All right, so you can just continue on, and then you can do little bits of the shingles. Again, let's get... Now let's see if I can get, again, you want to apply texture. Let's see, let's get some glues. Here's a gray. Probably the gray will probably work. But let me go, see, I go back here and flip back here and do a test. All right, that's too gray. Let's see if I can do it with, oh, here, let's try this blue. And that's going to be too blue. I know I have a kind of a grainy blue and gray. Ah, this is the color I'm looking for right here. And there's no names on these, so I can't even tell you what color it is. That's the color I'm looking for. It's a gray. It's like almost like a slate blue gray. And so what I'm going to do now is go on top of this. Going, thanks for visiting while coloring. I can see process. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. There's a place for both. There's a place for both. Okay, so now I think I want to just do a little bit of like some little zigzaggy lines here and there. And again, if you're not using the, one of the things I like about the super tip crayon, markers, is you can get different, you can get thick lines, you can get a medium line, and you can get a fine line. So you can, you know, get variations in widths of lines. That's one of the reasons I like these super tips. But if you don't think you can get the tiny little lines with a marker, even at the point, I'm pointing it straight down to get a nice tip, then use your gel pen, okay? Use gel pens. So I'm just going to kind of do a little bit of nothing fancy, just a little bit of zigzaggy stuff. See? Just a little bit of zigzaggy stuff. And if I want even a little bit lighter, let's test this purple out here. That might work. Just kind of do a few zigs. I'm not trying to go over every single color book line. I'm just kind of trying to give you the indication that it's kind of rough, that's kind of shingly. Now again, if you want to go in there and draw every little shingle, nothing wrong with that. You're more than welcome to spend 5 hours on every little shingle. You know, that's the, yeah, you know, it just all depends on how much time you want to spend on it. I'm just not that, it almost makes me happier when it's not perfect. That's just, it gives it more, for me, it gives it more personality. That's just me though, guys. If it bothers you not to have something, you know, exactly on the lines, then take all the time you need. So I just want to indicate essence of shingles. So like there's one that's done, there's one that's not. So I've gone from this to that. Hey, Anonymous. Okay, so. All right. So then you get the idea on the roofs. All right, so let's come over here again and do a little something. Like I said, I want to do something with maybe some gel pen or something. They do. They last forever. I think I have 3 sets of them, and maybe out of each set, out of the oldest 2 sets, and I've had them years, some of the older ones, they don't dry out. You can use them up. But and as long as you keep the cap on them, now, you know, you got to keep the caps on them. These are just the most awesome kids Crayola water-based markers ever. They're awesome. All right, so let's go over here and just see what, you know, what I might want to do in here. Okay, let's go ahead and do... Let's just say that the wavy stuff that people were asking about, let's just say it is like the fire that's coming from behind the castle. So I would just start with my lightest, or, you know, medium orange, let's say. Orange. Okay, that pencil sharpener didn't. Let's try this. Okay, well, that one's not wanting to sharpen this pencil for some reason. Did I pick up a bad pencil? I very well could have, but we'll see. Okay, what time is it? Okay, I'll spend a few more minutes, about 15 or 20 more minutes. Okay, so the first thing I would do is I would go in here and find all the parts, that, you know, those little wavy things, and I would just do a nice light coat of the orange. That's just the base. So in this case, all those wavy things, they could be clouds, they could be water, it could be smoke, it could be fire, it could be anything. Just because they're the shape of waves doesn't have to make them be water. So I'm going to go in here and find all the waves. So it comes around this way too. There's some bird wings there. I'm not sure what that's going on. But I'm just going to do a very light coat over all the waves. Just going to find them all. Now, there's going to be a variation in there. There's going to be dark and lights. But I'm just getting a base coat. Again, you could do this with a brush if you want. Get in there with your a wash, you know. But I'm just trying to do some different kinds of... I want to do some different applications for you. And remember, it'll go over like, all right, so here's purple right there. The orange will go over the paint. Okay. So I'm going to find all the places that are the water. I may have to open, I'm not going to be here that much longer, guys. Maybe 20 minutes or so. You know, and some of it's a little tricky. You got to kind of look at where things are going. That's part of it. This is part of it. That's bird wing there. And again, if you're not sure and you color something the wrong thing, no, Kerby is not going to email you and say you colored that wrong. Okay, that's a Jack and the Beanstalk. Kind of, see, there's a piece of a castle over here, so I've got to cut, you know, do something with that later. No one's got, the color book artists are not going to email you and say, you colored that wrong. You're the boss of your color book, remember. You're the boss of your art journals, your mixed media. Okay, that's a little fish thing there. This background here. That actually is going to be part of it. Now you can always just do a complete, if there was like more of one thing in here than another, you could just do a full-on wash over the whole thing. Like I'm going to do a monochromatic. Okay, here's an example. No, that's, well, kind of, but okay, well, this might be a good example. Okay, so these shells here, all the tentacles coming out, I'm going to have this coral color. Okay. So look, I just colored a wash over that, knowing that not every bit of this is going to be that coral color. But I put the coral wash over all the tentacles. Now I can go back and color over any of this. Remember I showed you, look, white pencil over black paint. but I wanted to show you the bird. Okay, well, here's an example. Look at this. I just did a complete wash over all that. All this MAC is not going to be that tan color. Okay, here. This is going to be a snow leopard. So you can see I've already started filling in the snow part of the leopard. But look, all this is not going to be blue. Or it could be, but it may not be. But I just did a complete wash over the whole thing. Then I'm going back in there. Okay, here's another example. These tentacles here. I was not careful to go in there and paint right on top of the tentacles. See how it went over the edge, out of line? Doesn't matter. You can color pencil over that. Yeah, I know, right, Jean? Okay, here, this is going to be a monochromatic bluebirds page. All these birds are going to be probably some shade of blue. And you can see I just did a complete wash over it. That's where somebody emailed me, I think, and said, that just, well, never mind, I'm not going to say it on recording. This is just all a wash here. No shading, no blending yet. Here's where we've done some of the background here. And then I splattered here to kind of show you where what it will look like when it's finished. So you can see where I've splattered here and not splattered here. So it'll go to this eventually. See how all that splattered and shaded in here? Okay, that'll be on here too. Same thing for the boats, you know. Any of it. You can put as much wash up. I could have washed the whole thing orange and then picked out the animals. You know, it just depends on, I guess, what you feel like doing at the time, at the moment. So what I want to do, though, is I'll go through and find all the orange fiery waves. And then I'll go back in and add darker orange and make it look like fire water. Fire water. Go make fire water. You need to finish a page. You forget what you're doing? Well, I guess if you think you might forget where you are, this is just how I'm tackling this book. You know, I've got plenty of other pages where I finished the whole page. Maybe not in one sitting here with you guys, but I've got plenty of pages that are completed, right? But in this book, I just wanted to kind of challenge myself to eventually finish this whole book. And the only way I'm probably going to finish this whole book is doing it in bits at a time. Little bits here and there, like I'm doing here. You know, if I forget a color, like if I forget that that's this color blue or something, then I'll just say, well, was it that blue? No, it wasn't that one. Was it this? No, it wasn't that. Just guess at it, find it, figure it out. You know? All right, so let's see. There's some kind of a little dragon. Here's some more orangey, fiery bits. I'm not going to do it all right now because then I won't get past this. And I don't want you to just see me try to pick out just the orange. I want you to see me do some more color on it. And then after, I'll spend about 5 minutes or 10 minutes. What time is it? Okay, let me spend 5 more minutes doing this. And then I will back the camera out and spend about 5 minutes looking at some of my pages that I've already finished, that are done. And then we'll be done for the day. Don't forget Barb streams at 2 on YouTube. She streams only on YouTube now. Barb Owen. So check her. I mean, peruse the awesomeness. That is Barb at 2 Eastern. All right. There's more in here. See, there's more right here. So I won't do all of it right now, but I want you to see where we're going with it. So I'm going to do all this as those flames or water, whatever you want it to be at the moment. There's some more in there. I'm still missing some here. You just got to kind of go in there and follow the path of where they're going. But I think you get the idea. So let's just go ahead. Let's do this one right here. All right, so now I'm going to get my darker orange and maybe even just maybe a little bit of red. Let's test this red. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. All right, so now I've got the light orange done. Now I'm going to take the pumpkin orange, the darker orange, and now I'm going to get in there and do a little bit more. I'm going to follow the shadows that are already on the color book page. See some of the shadows. Let's see. See some of the lines where the shading already is for you? All right, so now I'm going to attach or tackle those edges next. All right, I've got like a nice little base of orange so I know where I'm going. And I can still pick that orange back up, the lighter orange. I can still pick that back up and do more blending, okay? I just wanted to pick out all the oranges, find them all. All right, so I found the bulk of them. So now I can go in here and do some of the shading here where the color book has already got shading for you. I gotta set it back down. My arm's getting tired holding it up in the air. Okay, so now I can do that. But I can also go in here with my marker and pick out some of the, let's just say, because like I said, I wanted this to be fire. And pick out some brighter reds. Now, while it's wet, you can also, kind of smear it a little. Now, they don't blend. They're not watercolor markers like blendable. I mean, they might touch each other and blend a little bit, but don't try to count on it. Don't count on your Crayola markers to blend like watercolor. All right, so now I can go back in there. It's best to make sure your marker's dry. Otherwise, you can smear it right off. But they dry pretty quick. I mean, almost instantaneously. And then just get back in there with a little bit more. And maybe even a little bit of yellow. Do I want some yellow in there? Maybe. Maybe I want it even more fiery. Let's put some yellow in there. So you just have to do it in stages. You know, that's how I do it anyway. I do it in stages. something like that. So get in there with your markers. Make sure it's dry. And then you can get back in here with your pencil and do more blending. So we kind of go from like that to this. And take more time, guys. I am kind of rushing it. You can probably tell. But you can go from like this to this with your markers and your pencil. Now the blending is from the pencil. Okay. And there's a little bit of a castle even right in there. I can just go ahead and color that in if I want, even though this has a wash on it. But get in there with my blue top, a little bit of white highlight. Okay. Hey, Terry Trouble, how you doing? How's your arm? Yes, we try not to make Terry, we don't want Terry to mod too hard with her arm. Don't mod too much. All right, so here's some more of that fiery stuff coming across here. And then get back in there with some pencil. So you can see how the fire is going to come across the castle. Right? It'll be like that. So here you can see, here is just with a little bit of orange pencil, a little bit of orange pencil, and then you can get in here and do this with it. Okay, but not staying. Okay. All right. Well, thanks for coming and stopping in. Hope you're doing all right. You said you're doing okay. All right. So something like that. Okay. Let me back out, Vern. Oh, okay. All right, let's refocus. Where's my, one of my cards here to, or something here to focus. Nice and bright. All right, so yeah, there we go, guys. So you can see how little we actually got done when we zoom out, right? You can see this is all we got done, you know. Well, we got a little bit detail over there. Okay, so let me just show you a little bit. I'll do a little bit of flipping through some of the books that we've done some things in. And then, yeah, I hope y'all will have a good weekend. So we've been working in the Imagimorphia. Again, there's really not much completed in here except maybe this page here with the Stickles spider web. Everything else in this particular book is I've worked on washing areas and then coloring in the backgrounds, or at least the start of backgrounds. So that's pretty much all that we're working on so far in this book. There's no completed pages in this book, okay, in the Imagimorphia. Now in Animorphia, I'll just show you a few here. In the Animorphia, we have a few completed pages. Again, here's the start of a wash. Okay, but let me flip through some of the to the pages that are done. And I know most of y'all have probably seen these, but I'll just do a quick flip of some of these and the ones in my binder. I don't cut pages out of the books that are like 9x9, 10x10. I only take the pages so far out of the books that are 8.5x11. And even those, okay, Carrie, I'll look in a minute. Even the ones that I've cut out of the 8.5 by 11 are not ones that are like stories. Like, for instance, like Game of Thrones, even though that's a 9 by 9 book, if it was an 8.5 by 11, I wouldn't cut those pages out because it's like a story. And if you just take a page out of the story, you're just, you know, taking a page out of the story. Whereas like my Jasmine or Bennett Klein, they're not a continuous story, so I'll take them out. And they're only one-sided. They're not double-sided. So that's another thing that you might consider. So you can see these are done. Some iguanas. This one's in the process. I have a few in process. In process. So there's a couple in there. So in my binder here, you can see. So I also have put, I've divided them up by the color book, by the artist. So like right here at the beginning, I have my Bennett Klein ones. So, and they're, you're going to see a glare because they're in plastic sleeves. I do have stickles on some of them like this. You can maybe, yeah, it's probably going to be tough with the, in the sleeves, but there's stickles on some of them. Where's my, let me get my color back here. Hang on, guys. Let's get the color back. See, well, let me take one out because I want you to see the stickles on them. So I can add, if you add some glitter to them, there we go. So on this one, for example, there's glitter. Stickles. See? Then I added her own, my own smoke bit there. See, with color pencil. And then here, this one is also a Bennett Klein. No glitter on this one. But you can see how all the paint, this is all paint. Paint, paint, paint. Okay, so let's get the, there we go. Then this is my Doodlers Anonymous. Again, I'm just going to do a quick little flip to show you. But like this page here, there was nothing in the background. I added all the snow and the stars and all that. You have to be the boss of your color book. This page right here, there was no water, no stars. There wasn't even a lantern. I painted, I drew that in. So do whatever, you know, do whatever. Water dripping. That's all added with paint. This is all added with paint. This is all added with paint. And then we did all these letters. Friends in the box. Fibs. Added all those letters. Okay. So I'm just going to do a flip through here. Added collage bits, water, stars. Same for this page right here. I drew my own. This is all drawn in, painted in. Collage. You know, you do whatever. You know, you've seen how many pages we've cut out and put in art journals, mixed media journals, the napkin journal. Okay, here's a collage-y bit. She's collaged in. The little the clocks are all collaged in. Then here's my Jasmine Beckett Griffith pages. Okay. Again, none of this was there. The fire, the clouds, you know, add all that, add it all to whatever you want. I painted in all the clouds back there. The rain coming down is just paint. the water is all paint. The clouds in the background are paint. A couple of our Halloween pages, and you can see the stickles in her hair. And there you can see some of where we had stickles. And then the cupcake girl, she's got stickles on her cupcakes. Painted her hair, the little flyaway hairs. And this was the last one that we did for the Halloween. We made her the Children of the Corn. All this is painted in. None of this was here. You don't have to just go with what's there. Painted all that in, made her hair look like straw. Made her a little Children of the Corn paint for the fog. I think that's all that's in my binder here. So let's see. Do I have a couple others I can show you? So then in Pop Manga, we have a few pages colored in Pop Manga. So, well, you won't do it if you don't do it. This one we did with ink tints. And I wasn't really happy with it because, you know, ink tints are like watercolor pencils that are ink in a pencil. And I didn't like the background, but we just kept trucking along. Okay. So these are just some of the ones we've done in Pop Manga. The Narwhal Girl. Again, paint, paint, pencil on paint, put our own stars, put our own planets. That's another one. Again, put in your own stars, planets, glow, all that. So that's out of the Pop Manga. Let's see. Oh, I do have there are a couple other ones in my binder. I just realized because they must be in the back. Yeah, because I have a couple from my, all right, here's one from a, this one's from a comic book color book. Here, these are from, this is from the Somerset Studio Coloring Studio, as are both of these. And so we added our own drips. And this was this page was designed by Tim Holtz. And we colored this one and added all these gears. These are die cuts. We added our own die cuts to it. Added a watch part. Made a collage out of it. Painted the hands of the collage. Because, you know, that's what I do. Collage and pencil. And then this one we did. This was out of the coloring studio by Somerset. And this is all just crayons. This is all just Crayola crayons. Right out of the box. So, yeah, I think that now that's all that's in the binder. And the look, let's go. Now, a couple of these I've sent to Eileen. I sent one to Eileen, one to Paula, so I don't have them all. This one's in process, not done. What else is in here? So, I have colored a few more out of this book that I've sent. This one. Remember, guys, I do do pencil portraits commissions for a living. There's one more in here I really like. This one. This one has a three-part. This has a three-part video on it. How to do this one. So that's out of the look by Suwa. Looking, guys, to see. Anyway, let me look up here on the shelf. Is there anything else? There's more, but I can't really dig them out right now. But I just want to give you an idea. So anyway, guys, I hope y'all enjoyed just doing that. Yeah, I've done some in a couple pages in the water one. Hang on, this is the Lost Ocean. Here we go. I've done a couple in the Lost Ocean. This one's not finished, but you can see where we've used stickles in this one. So it's in process. And then this one here. This was all done with the detail. This is paint. This is paint. This is paint. And then all the little details here are done with the markers. So, yeah. All right, guys. Well, I hope y'all have a great weekend. Color, make something, collage something, paint something, sketch something. So, y'all have a great weekend. Thanks, guys. I appreciate y'all being here. Hope everybody has a safe and fun weekend. And, yeah. Bye-bye, guys. Have a great weekend. Thanks for joining.